I have already uploaded a video on omitted variable bias, a little more about it, that what are the consequences if we omit a relevant variable and if we include an irrelevant variable. This is chapter 6, basically Econometrics by Christopher Dougherty. You can read that chapter. So you see we have four scenarios. One is that y is function of x2 and you fit y as function of x2. So this is a correct case. This one is correct one. And second one is that you have x2, x3 and you fit this x2. So it means you are basically omitting a relevant variable because x3 should have been here. Third case is that you have x2, but you have fitted a model x2 and x3, so it's again leading to the inclusion of irrelevant variable. And this is okay, you have x2, x3 and you have fitted a model. Fine. So you see this is okay. This one is okay. In this case, you have biased coefficients. Why these are biased? I have already discussed. I am going to discuss it again. Standard errors are invalid. Look here that you have not included x3, and as a result, what happens that this term appears here. But when you estimate this model, this term is also included here. Let's look at this. So you see. This beta 3 is effect of x3 holding effect of x2 constant. This is effect of x2 and x3. Basically, this is a mediating, these two are related with each other, and this is measured by covariance between x3 and x2 divided by variance of x2. So this is another term which is basically, this effect is captured by beta 2 hat if you don't include x3. Next one is, okay, just a minute, yes. So you can drive it, you place value of yi here, this is the value of yi here, you place the value of y bar here, and then you summarize it, and you calculate it, and at the end of these simplifications, you have this term and this one, its mean is zero, so this will vanish and you are left with this. This one, expected value of ui will be zero, so therefore that term is vanished and you have this added value. This is basically a bias in beta 2. When you have x3 as relevant variable but you don't include it, then beta 2 actually is not equal to this one beta 2, rather it has some bias. We'll demonstrate it empirically through an example given in the book. So you see we are basically regressing S on a variable ASV ABC and SM. So you have this coefficient 1.37. Is it biased upward? Is it biased downward? That depends what is the correlation between these two. If it's positive and you don't include SM, then beta 2 will be upward biased. Now we are going to take a case where you have, you see the correlation between SV and ASVM is 0.359, which is positive, and when you exclude SM, when you have excluded SM, what is this one? 1.58. This one, this should have been 1.37 if you have included SM. So what's the result? That when you regress, when you include both relevant variables in the model, its coefficient is 1.37. When you don't include this one, this impact is also covered, captured by this one. So you have 1.58. Why it's upward? Because correlation between these two variables is positive. Another thing which you need to notice down is, same is the case when you have included only SM and not this one, so it is 0.35, whereas when you include both, it is basically 0.19. So when both variables are included, it's 1.37 and 0.19. When you exclude this one, it is 0.35. And when you exclude this one, we have seen that this was 1.58. So this leads to biasness. Now look at the comparison between R square. When we regress on both relevant variables, we get R square equal to 0.29. When we regress S on this one, S on SM, that is the other two, the other variable is not included, your R square is 0.26 and 0.12. But your this correlation between R square is 0.29, whereas if you add these two, this is not equal to 0.29. So R square basically, when here you can say that R square also captures the effect of SM, and here 0.12, that's higher than usual because SM has also some impact of ASVC. So that's why we can't decide on the basis of R square whether all the relevant variables are included in the model or not. Let's go to the next one. So you have this, log of earning on S and experience. So in previous case, we have seen R square of two models that should have been 0.39, but actual R square, you see, if you, these two, so if you add these two, this is greater. But when you include both variables, it's not 0.340, it's rather 0.29. But if this correlation between S and experience is negative, that more schooling and if more experience means you have less schooling, you enter in labor market earlier, then those who have more schooling, then in that case, you see R square in this case is, where is R square? Okay, R square is 0.139. So correlation here is negative, so it means coefficient will be downward, coefficient will have downward, upward bias. So again, when you include S and experience, your coefficients are this one. When you only include S, coefficient is 0.06. So it means this is downward biased. This one should have been 0.09. And look at this. This is 0.04, but this actually is 0.04. But when you don't include, it's minus 0.09. And R square, we just compare the two R squares. In this case, when you include both variables, it's 0.139. And when you add these two, it's basically 0.11. So R square in this case is higher than sum of these two. Whereas in previous model, R square was less than sum of these two. So if there is positive association between omitted variable and included variable, R square is smaller for both variables than the sum of the other two two models, and if it's negative, R square for collective model, both variables may be more than sum of these two. So it depends on the magnitude of the bias. So what I'm talking here about, that if you exclude an irrelevant variable, relevant variable, then it may lead to bias in OLS estimators. Now we have the second case. If you include an irrelevant variable, what happens? That is, your actual model is this one, but you have estimated this one. What happens with that? Your coefficients are unbiased, but they become inefficient. Why they become inefficient? The standard errors increase. Why that increase? Let's see. So you see, this term is added. As we know that R square will be definitely less than 1. So therefore, this term will be greater than greater than 1. So this will make this number higher than if this term was not included. So therefore, it means sigma square beta 2 hat will have higher standard errors than when you include an irrelevant variable, then if you don't include. If you don't include, this will be 0, 1 over 1, so this will be the standard error. So if you include an irrelevant variable, OLS estimator remains unbiased, but they become inefficient because standard error of beta 2 hat will increase. So we see again that we are regressing log of earning on S, experience and male, and we think that some variable is irrelevant. What happens? Here you have included age, its coefficient is minus 0.007, and what happens when you and correlation between S and the age is minus 0.03. So what happens that when you include age, coefficients are more or less same, standard errors 0.010, 0.0108, so standard errors may increase, so the standard errors will inflate. So that's all from this, that when you include irrelevant variables, what happens? Your standard errors become large as compared to when that irrelevant variable is not included. You can compare this set with this set. For more, you can read the specification of regression variables. It's not model selection. Model selection is different one. I'll also try to demonstrate including excluding a relevant variable also leads to sometimes one may conclude that economic theory does not hold, and that I will do from econometric analysis from Green chapter 4 example of gasoline consumption per capita on prices. So prices and gasoline consumption per capita will have positive relationship, whereas we assume that if prices will go up, gasoline consumption per capita will go down. Basically there is an income variable which should have been in the model. So I'll show in my next videos. Please keep on watching. Take care. Thank you.